So guys, hello and welcome to this tutorial. Now we are going to talk about H-split and B-split. Actually, the sheer purpose of this tutorial is because when I was talking about split in the previous tutorial, I actually forgot to use H-split and B-split because it would have been more easier, you know, with those examples. But still, I prefer you guys watch that video before and then come to this video and by clicking on this I icon so that you guys understand, because I'm going to jump skip forward in this tutorial really fast. So the syntax is numpy.hsplit and then array name and section. The same goes for vsplit. So by hsplit, what do I mean is I'm going to split, but the axis is going to be 1, and for vsplit the axis is going to be 0. So vertical means this axis, right? 0th axis and the 0 axis, and hsplit means the axis 1. So I just don't need to mention the axis in this case. So basically hsplit is nothing but the split function just with axis 1, which I don't need to mention obviously, and vsplit is nothing but the split function with axis as 0. So I'll show you an example, the same example that I had in the previous tutorial. So first of all, I'll print out arr and not arr, just arr, and just run this code. And after that, I'm going to do this thing. I'm just going to print out numpy.split, not split, vsplit in this case. So vsplit, and the axis is going to be 0. So there are only, we are left only with two parameters, the array name and then the section. So see, I told you when the, you know, when you're splitting along the 0 axis, then you need to take care of the number of rows. There are 4 rows, so you can divide 4 by 2. So 4 rows can be divided into 2 sections. So you got 2 arrays specifically. So if you try to divide 4 by 3 now, it will give me an error. Why? Because I, you know, I specifically took 3 because 6 is divisible by 3. But we are using axis as 0. So we need to take care of number of rows. That's why it won't work. But if you mention hsplit, now it will work because 6 is divisible by 3, so you can get 3 different sections as we got over here. I'll just increase the size so that you guys see. And if you try to use 2 now, obviously 6 is again divisible by 2, so again you'll get 2 sections of this whole array. Or 2 section, a better word is 2 subarrays actually. So I think that's all from my side for this tutorial. You can subscribe to my channel to get more regular updates regarding programming related content. So that's all. Stay tuned and keep learning. Thank you.